in the AFC East tour. How is it with the Dolphins so far?
Very, very honored, blessed to be here. My dad was from Miami. I have a lot of family from Miami. I grew up a Dolphins fan, so this is kind of a dream come true.
Braxton, early impressions of this offense, what you like about it?
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. Obviously went through OTAs, learned the playbook as much as you can there, and then, you know, you're kind of reinstalling and going over and really getting the finite details of everything. But it's been a lot of fun. It's been a pretty quick learning curve. There's a lot of crossover there, but I'm excited.
So what happened on the long touchdown?
Just the go ball. Skyler put it in a perfect place. We connected on a deep one.
How much does offensive playing time matter to you? Obviously, you're a team guy, but everybody wants to play. Was that something that was important to you when you signed here?
Yeah, I think it's important every year. Obviously, you want to contribute however you can, and you want to help the team win however you can. And, I think you get what you carve out. And so we'll see what happens there.
Speaking of that, you've kind of carved out a career in the NFL out of your first year where you're on the fringe. Talk about your development, what you can do now, maybe that you couldn't do when you got
there. You know, I think it's year to year you kind of got to go back and, you know, self-scout and see what you have to do better. And, you know, especially early, it's really everything. And I've tried to really hone in on, the things that I thought I was worst at year in and year out. And, obviously from 2018 to now, I think I've made some decent strides, and, you know, hopefully again in 4 or 5 years, if I'm lucky enough, I'll look back and say the same thing. But, you know, it's really year to year is different, and I feel good about where I'm at right now.
So what were you working on initially that you couldn't do or you needed to do?
You know, that's gonna stay with me. Hopefully it worked. It's a year to year process, and just trying to be the best all around football player you can be going into the next year.
Braxton, the decision to switch to number 0, was it just it's new, it's cool, or was there actually a...
No, I mean, it was new, it was different, it was cool, and, you know, when I got here, there wasn't much open as it was. So kind of fell into it, and, you know, I like it, I'm embracing it, and, it's the first year ever, so I think that's, you know, kind of a nuance to it. But yeah, I'm excited for it.
Do you come up with like cool nicknames for it, like Agent Zero?
Gilbert Arenas, you know, that's him, you know. But everybody says that, and so, you know, I guess it sticks, but I can't say I coined that one, no.
You said you grew up a Dolphin fan,
mm-hmm.
And yet there were plenty of times that you made some plays that hurt the Dolphins. What was that like, including right there in that stadium?
Yeah, it's the NFL. You can grow up a fan, but obviously when you get here, it becomes a career, a business, and, you know, things change. And, you know, obviously when I signed back here, I became the biggest fan again. But it's really cool to be here.
And what about your family? They no more divided loyalties or anything?
No more divided loyalties. My dad was. His heart was hurting for the last 5 years, my tour of the AFC East, as he called it. But now he's happier than he's ever been.
Have you been out to the Inter Miami games?
I have not yet. I need to.
What do you think of the addition of Messi to Miami?
I think it's incredible. I mean, obviously, Miami, South Florida sports has been incredible really in the last year. I mean, with the deep playoff runs from the 8 seeds and all that, it's really cool to watch. And, you know, we obviously have a chance to continue that, and I think that's the most exciting part. But, you know, Messi coming to Miami is just it's just something else. It's very Miami.
What have you learned so far from Wes Welker, a guy who has a pretty similar build to you and accomplished a lot in the NFL?
What do you mean by that? I wish I would have seen his face. A lot. Obviously, he did it for a long, long time, and I don't think, though. I mean, even if you look at, if you really like study him and the way he runs routes was different, and I think he kind of like coined that, and then you have kind of a lineage after that took from that, and so I've been watching him since I really can remember football. And again, there's some things that he does that you just can't replicate, because it was exactly, you know, who he is, and, you know, nobody can be that. And kind of the same thing on the opposite side of the spectrum from, you know, like Tyreek, there's some things he does that you just can't replicate because you don't exactly have what he has. But I think it's the overall knowledge and the nuances and the intricate details of football and, you know, what we're trying to accomplish in a play. And, you know, hearing him talk about those things and picking up on that, I think that really has been, it's been really cool from my standpoint, because you pick up on those things and, you know, you might not get the ball that play, but you might have done exactly what you're supposed to do to open up somebody else. And so, you know, I'm obviously trying to be a sponge with the offense and, you know, obviously with Coach Welker as well, but it's been really cool.
Braxton, you've been around Tua now for 4 months, just overall impressions.
I'm very impressed. Just, you know, as a human, from a character standpoint, and obviously as a leader, as a teammate, very personable. Knows how to get the attention of a huddle. Very confident, as he should be. And, you know, he's been extremely accurate. And you know, I really can't say enough good things about him. And I'm happy and I'm excited to play with him.